Yo guys, what up? French is here coming to you today. We got a video, of course, and in the background you might be wondering, what the hell is that? Yeah, that's Battlefield 4. I recently got on and played some Battlefield 4 with one of my good buddies, Eli, who also is Versa Omega. He's part of the Versa clan, so shout out to Eli for hopping on some Battlefield 4 with me. And it's one of those games that I still love to play. I played this game more than Call of Duty when Ghost came out. This was one of the first shooters I had on Xbox One, and I still thoroughly enjoyed this game. They've done so many things to this game to make this game dramatically better. And, you know, it took them a while to get it to the state it currently is now. But the game, if there was a lot of you that were really skeptical and had really bad experiences with Battlefield 4 when it first came out, now is the time I would say go back, especially with the EA Access program. You pay $5 a month, you can go back and play a bunch of the games in the vault. Battlefield 4 is one of those games. Speaking of which, also, we're going to have Battlefield Hardline coming out in March, and I don't know, man, I'm just trying to kind of get in the mood of playing some Battlefield before Hardline comes out, because I'm super excited to play Battlefield Hardline when it comes out. I'm more excited about Battlefield Hardline than I think any other game, maybe except Batman Arkham Knight, because that's honestly the only game I have pre-ordered right now for the whole entire 2015 year of gaming. Is Arkham Knight, because I'm kind of done doing the whole pre-order thing, but that's kind of besides the point. But yeah, we're going to be talking a little bit about Battlefield Hardline today, kind of my thoughts and prayers and hopes, and then we're going to kind of get into, you know, like, what happened to just gaming for fun? You know, that's one of those things, is gaming is such a casual thing, and it's turned into a sweat fest, and so many people just take it so serious now. It takes a lot of the fun out of it, but kick back, relax. Enjoy some Operation Dawnbreaker Dom with me and Eli, just kind of going hard with our M16A4s, I believe they are. I don't even remember the name, honestly. I'm pretty sure it's an M16A4, but nonetheless, enjoy that in the background. Now, Battlefield Hardline. Okay, like I said, I'm really excited about this game. One, based on the fact that I'm just not really into Call of Duty anymore. It's, you know, Advanced Warfare, I hit First Prestige, and I kind of just stopped playing the game, to be honest with you, because it's just not fun. I get into a pub match and it's sweaty as hell. I feel like I'm playing a game battles match. It's not one of those games where you can just sit back, have the controller, and just play the game now. You have to kind of concentrate really hard, and that's not kind of my game to play. Like, I like to, you know, I got the SCUF controller, I got the Astros, you know, that's just me personally. That's just how I like to do things. But at the same time, I still like to play games with my friends and relax, and this is what we're doing. You know, we kind of put the tryhard pants on a little bit because, you know, we started losing, so we put on our assault class with the medics and shit and kind of were reviving and hopping on flags, but that's fun to me. Like, we're not, like, over tryhard, and we're not teabagging kids. We're not, like, insulting, you know, all these other people that are playing in the game. We're just playing as friends. And that's one of those things that with a lot of games nowadays, dude, they're, like, you don't have that quality anymore. Like I said, Advanced Warfare is such a sweat fest, and then, you know, Destiny is like an endless grind. I still thoroughly enjoy playing Destiny. You know, I mean, I've been playing Destiny with a little bit with my brother, who just got into Destiny recently, and he's going hard in the paint. He passed me on levels recently, which is pretty crazy, so he's really enjoying that, and I'm enjoying just being able to play games with friends. And, you know, I'm gonna get, you know, me and Petey have been talking about maybe playing Minecraft on Xbox One. You know, that's just, it's a lot of the games, maybe it's my attitude towards gaming is changing. I'm getting older. I just want to relax and play. I don't want to take it so serious. Black Ops 2 was the most serious I ever took a video game, to be honest with you. Like, I was so sweaty on Black Ops 2. You can look back at my videos. I'm Halo jumping all over the place. Like, you know, maybe that's part of it because I have the SCUF controller or whatnot, but I hate losing. But I find myself nowadays, I just want to put a disc in and just play the game. And just relax, because, you know, there's a lot of things outside of gaming in general that in my life that I have that I'm going through, and it's one of those things. Like I said, I just want to relax and play games, man. And, you know, Battlefield Hardline looks like it's going to be a game that's going to be a lot of fun to play. It also looks like a game that I'm thoroughly going to enjoy playing with friends. And that's, you know, a lot of people I know are very skeptical of Battlefield because of what happened with the release, and at the same time, I give you full credit for being skeptical of that. But at the same time, man, it's kind of a different developer. It's Visceral instead of DICE. I mean, it's still got the Frostbite engine. It still kind of looks like Battlefield 4, but it doesn't play like Battlefield 4 from everything that I've heard and read. And I'm really excited for the beta, which probably should be out in the next month, is my guess, since the game comes out in March. So you'll definitely be seeing that on the channel when the beta comes. I'm going to be going hard on the beta. Like Petey goes hard on the Halo 5 beta, and look out soon at the end of the week for his review of Halo 5, the beta. I'm really looking forward to that video, so make sure you guys check that out. All the links for a few of the channels that I'm really cool with are in the description always, so make sure you always check them out. And give them a follow on Twitter, and, you know, sub to their channels. Support all the people that support me. But, like I said, that's the, you know what I mean? I kind of rolled everything together, I guess you could say, with, you know, games not being as fun. But it's to the point where I don't know if it's the esports thing or if it's that just kids take games so serious now. Like, I always get clan invites. I get these, you know, you look on these Xbox Live bios and these kids are like hitting the sticks harder than you, you know, OBJ Slayer, like, since 94. Like, it's like the stupidest shit I see. And it's just like, it's cool to be, take something serious and a hobby serious, like YouTube taking it serious, like having fun. And, you know, having pride, that's an amazing thing to have. And when you're good at something, you want to show people. I think people forget that. This is a hobby. These games are for fun. You're not making money off this. If you're making money off of YouTube, I can understand maybe taking games more seriously. But at the same time, man, honestly, people just need to kind of chill out and have fun. If more people had fun, I think more of these games would be a hell of a lot more enjoyable. And shit, that's probably why I don't like playing Call of Duty as much anymore, is because it's like a no-fun zone. You get into a lobby and people are teabagging each other. People are, you know, Halo hopping around, and, you know, everybody has a scuff controller and they're hopped up on gamma, and that's just kind of how it is. But what do you guys think? Is gaming not as fun as it used to be? Did it lose that flair of nostalgia? Like we were talking about that on the Team Green podcast the other day. Like, those old games that you played, man, I can remember playing these games for hours and having fun. I don't remember the last time I played Call of Duty for more than 45 minutes, unless it was zombies with some of my friends. But that's all for me, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed the commentary. Look out for another video coming soon. And until next time, I'll talk to you guys later. I'm out. Peace.